Sure. I think there is a paraphrasing we usually do when there is a client conversations, and in my several conversations with the prospects and clients, this has come up always, that we are data rich, information poor, insight starved. Can you help solve our problem? Now today, the quantum of data, the velocity of data, is throwing unprecedented challenges for the CXOs, which also means that it's not about the volume, variety, veracity of the data. It's also about making a meaning out of it. And for a CXO, more important in terms of data aggregation or data wrangling, it's all about decision making. I mean, if you take a life of a typical human being, we take about an average of about 64 decisions a day, strategic, tactical, operational. For all these decisions, think of a scenario where algorithms, personalized, self-learned, intuitive, can start making decisions for you. And that's where the whole aspect for the organizations and for the CXOs today is that let's start making meaning out of the data, which is very important. CRO concept, customer risk and operations part of analytics, is a construct which we took some time in terms of brainstorming how we should think in terms of possibly doing this thing. Now, just to pull back around this thing, today the majority of the enterprises today are looking at how do you embed smart, embedded and pervasive kind of, let's say, analytics within the organization. Now, for that to happen, one has to make a meaning out of this entire analysis. And if you look at the whole landscape of analytics, there are dime a dozen offerings, capabilities, solutions, consulting frameworks today. Now, if you pitch to a prospect or a client today, you will say, okay, I'm doing a customer analytics aspect for you. But within customer analytics, there are sub-segments and buckets of customer analytics, customer acquisition, upsell, cross-sell, the whole aspect of journey. Now, when you realize and correlate with this thing today, the biggest aspect for an organization is to reimagine themselves, which is about transformation. And transformation is all about deconstructing the value chain of the businesses and putting all these smart technologies. So we went ahead with this whole idea of saying, look, we will look at all these buckets and subsegment of analytics. And if you just spread it out, these are 2,200 capabilities within analytics. Now, for a prospect to understand these 2,000 plus capabilities, it's simply not fathomable. So what we came out with, let's aggregate and bunch these all capabilities, these several capabilities, under three buckets. One, the biggest bucket where the consumption happens about analytics, which is customer analytics. Customer acquisition, upsell, cross-sell kind of a thing is all housed in that particular bucket. The second bucket is the risk. Risk includes risk, financial, aspects of the risk, fraud, regulatory, compliance, anything to do with anomaly detection, anything to do with, let's say, you take the usual rules today, GDPR and all. Everything is housed in terms of risk and fraud analytics over there. Now, what is left is a aspect where what we say the operations analytics is pretty much the shared service piece, the finance analytics, talent analytics, supply chain, FP&A, spend analytics. So CRO essentially is an aggregation of the offerings of analytics bunched under these three buckets. And to make it simpler, the clients then will pick up whether they want the C piece, R piece or O piece just to implement within their organization. Well, it's always a holy grail when we say an Indian market always have different nuances and challenges as opposed to what we see the US and UK market. And I think the biggest challenge today is, one, we say the talent piece in the Indian market. Personally, I've seen a lot of, I would say, half-baked, immature talent running organizations in terms of analytics. So that's one aspect about how do we tackle that. The second aspect, now coming back to the organization from an Indian point of view, is we also need to define the agenda and charter of analytics from a board level. Unless there is a top-down mandate, how analytics can permeate within the organization, that has to come from the organizational CXOs, from the Indian context, that look, the analytics will be embedded, will be functional in all the streams of company rather than just taking one silo, one particular function or business use cases and try to run with that. The second aspect of Indian organization in terms of adoption of analytics is we've always had this scenario that technologically we are very, very sound. We are doing all that kind of a, let's say, mature work of analytics and AI with the US clients, UK clients. Why can't we replicate some of these use cases in the Indian context? So a lot of that best practice sharing also needs to happen. The third piece aspect of this is the government also needs to support from a research innovation point of view, because analytics breed a lot of thinking. That's the cognitive side of the thinking. For that needs to happen, the Indian scenario in terms of how do we push more research, innovation needs to happen. Let me take this scenario today. Look at majority of the Fortune 500 organizations today. 35, 40 years back, an average age of an organization within S&P 500 index was about 35, 40 years. Today, any new age organization doesn't stay relevant for more than 10, 12 years. So that's the kind of disruption we are talking about from a context of global scenario. Now think of this scenario today that the fabric of the organization is all about disruption, innovation and transformation. And analytics and artificial intelligence is the underpinning of these three things. So for any organization to stay relevant, analytics is a game changer. What needs to happen in terms of the change of the mindset to your question is start treating analytics and artificial intelligence as a strategic asset and a strategic game changer for the organization. It cannot just be a tactical or an operational aspect, but it needs to be more strategic, it needs to be more determined at the board and a CXO level. Then the whole cascading of the impact in terms of data detonation, data getting more meaningful in terms of decisions will start coming in. The aspect for an organization in terms of this whole construct is, am I able to take decisions, intelligence and recommendations out of the data which is being thrown at any given point of time within the organization? As long as I'm able to take those decisions, I'm able to kind of have those scenarios where I'm getting those transformative impact, I think the fabric of the organization automatically will get weaved in a construct where we are talking about this new age organization today. Well, I've always believed that digital transformation is the most complicated, most, I would say, obtuse and very, very amorphous word, and the definition as well. Because today, on one side, we are talking about organizations getting disruptive. On the other side, under digital, we are talking about a barrage of new, what we say, exponential technologies. If I just simplify today, what is digital transformation? I will say these are three different dimensions to put in this way. One, the aspect of reimagining the customer experience under digital transformation. That's the holy grail for an organization to look at how do they can reimagine the whole experience in terms of personalized kind of a treatment is a new definition of digital transformation. The second piece on this dimension is what we say under digital transformation, how do we build new innovative product and services for the organization? Third piece is about changing the strategic business operational models, which also means that today if you look at these three dimensions coming together, we are talking about a transformation where the organization can go from an X to Y in the growth, can start looking at new profitability, new revenue streams, and also the new set of what we say data which can be made available for them to take decisions. I think we are in a very interesting time today. While there is a fair bit of maturity which has happened from analytics to artificial intelligence, we are still in a cusp of what we say artificial intelligence 1.0, which means the sophistication of image, voice, text and video is leading to new dimensions, new kind of innovation in this scenario. I think gradually we will start moving to what I say AI 2.0, which is a phenomenal aspect of IoT, cryptocurrencies, blockchain coming together, where AI will be embedded. And the third piece is the most, I would say, pivotal if we reach to that stage is, at that stage of AI 3.0, it will be singularity. Can we actually have machines mimic the human brain? And this is where the debate happens between Mark Zuckerberg and Elon Musk in terms of what are the benefits and the downside of AI. So it's very interesting in terms of looking at what AI can do for humanity.
For more updates from CXOTV, please like and subscribe to our channel.